I watched a debate where PhD Tony participated, and he came up with a very elegant method to definitely prove that the Earth cannot be flat. He mentioned four places on Earth that are equidistant from each other and stated that that is impossible on a flat plane. Let's first look into the second statement. When confronted with it, many people tend to answer that a square has four points that are equidistant to each other. But this is only true for three of the points. The fourth point always has a distance to one of the other points that is equal to the diagonal of the square. And the diagonal, obviously, is longer than the sides. You could change the form a bit into two triangles, but then again, there are always two points that are at a greater distance to each other than the others. The only way to solve this problem is to fold the second triangle upwards and adding two other triangles of the same size. You get a shape that is called a tetrahedron. And it is the only shape whose four endpoints are all equidistant to each other. So you cannot have four points equidistant to each other on a flat plane. This is step one. A tetrahedron has an inscribed and a circumscribed sphere. The radius of the circumscribed sphere happens to be 0.612374 times the distance between the two endpoints. The derivation can be found at a channel by the name of Mr. T's Math Videos. Link is in the description. Simple trigonometry shows that the angle between one endpoint, the center of the sphere, and any other endpoint comes out to be 109.47 degrees. If we apply this knowledge on the spherical Earth with a radius of 6,371 kilometers, the four points on the sphere should be at a length along the chord of 10,404 kilometers. This is, at the surface of the sphere, 12,172.4 kilometers apart. Notice that the height of the tetrahedron can be calculated to be around 8,500 kilometers. That's about a factor of 100 times the height of Mount Everest. The topography can therefore not be an excuse for flat earthers. You can easily find four points on the spherical Earth by choosing a random point on Google Earth and from this draw one line with a length of 12,172.4 kilometers in a random direction and another two lines with the same length in the direction of 120 degrees and 240 degrees relative to the first line. However, you would be very lucky if those four lines lie on solid ground. Most likely lies one or more in the ocean. So I selected four places on solid ground, equidistant from each other. Point 1 is located at Baidoa in Somalia. Point 2 at San Juan in Argentina. Point 3 at Inuvik in Canada. And point 4 in Brisbane, Australia. According to the distancenow.com website, the distance between each pair of these points are shown in this diagram. As you can see, they vary a little, from 12,072 to 12,293 kilometers, a deviation from the target distance of 12,172 of around 1% maximum. According to the measurement on Google Earth, the distances are shown in the same diagram. These are almost exactly the same as those from the distancenow.com. This is step 2. Now follows the hardest part. How can we show evidence that the claimed distance in Google Earth are the real distances? Most people accept Google's distances at face value, but not flat earthers. That is, if these distances don't support their silly narrative. I could show a couple of long-distance non-stop flights, like from Sydney to Santiago, but I know that flat earthers will say those flights don't exist. So I needed witnesses, people who have made these kind of long-distance non-stop flights. And I know a couple personally. There is André, an old schoolmate who lives near Perth, Australia nowadays. And he flew via Singapore, a distance of 10,503 kilometers and a flight time of 12 hours 40 minutes. Then there is Andries, a maintenance mechanic specialized in radar equipment for harbors and airports all over the world, who traveled, among many other destinations, to Hong Kong, 9,296 kilometers, flight time 11 hours 45 minutes. And Rio de Janeiro, 9,554 kilometers, flight time 11 hours and 55 minutes. Or my wife's best friend Donna, who is a retired business class stewardess on long distance flights by KLM. She has flown regularly to New Delhi, 6,369 kilometers, flight time 8 hours and 15 minutes. I myself have flown, among others, to Lima, Peru, via Curaçao, 7,964 kilometers, flight time 9 hours and 40 minutes. The average ground speed of all of these flights comes out at between 772 and 829 kilometers per hour. Taking into account the extra time a plane needs to reach its cruising altitude and the fact that it starts and ends at a ground speed of zero, these ground speeds are all consistent with the average cruising speed of a Boeing 747 of 885 kilometers per hour. In my opinion, this shows that the distances given by the distancenow.com are real distances. And since the distances on Google Earth conform with the distances given by the distancenow.com, the distances on Google Earth are also reliable. This shows that the four places, Baidoa, Somalia, Brisbane, Australia, Inuvik, Canada, and San Juan, Argentina, are in reality all equidistant from each other. And this in turn shows that the Earth cannot be flat.